start a program, simply click on the program that you would like to begin. If you can't find it for some reason, you can click on Programs and search for the name. Or you can go to Groups and search by the group that you are part of. So if you're part of a group and you click the drop-down, you'll see all of the programs that are in that group. Under Programs, you can also sort by things that you've created versus things that you've joined. Another thing I'll point out is it might look like you have duplicates of programs, and the name underneath it is important because these are the different groups going through that program. So sometimes you might have multiple groups going through the same program. In this case, we're going to go through the program that the group My Trainings is going through. So when I click on that, I can start. Before I start, on this page, you'll see a summary of this program. You'll see about how long it should take you to go through the whole thing, how many sessions it is, how many actions there are that you'll need to respond to. You'll see a summary. You can message the curator. You can see the bio of the curator and a list of the sessions. So let's begin. When I click Start, it takes me to this page. On the top, you'll see the Collapse or Expand option. And on the left-hand side, you'll see the Navigation panel. This allows you to jump between sessions by clicking on the session. And as you click on a session, as you scroll down, you'll see an outline of all of the actions. This also allows you to jump between actions. However, if you start with the very first action and click on it, it will then let you go through the lesson consecutively. Now, before we start going through the lesson, let me just highlight a couple things up here. We have these different options on the top. So this one will just give you the outline of the sessions. This one will actually take you to the group wall, and here you can see everybody that's in your group. You can message them, see their profiles, message the curator, and also change your settings if the curator has allowed it to take you off the group members list or remove you from the group leaderboard. When you click back on the group wall, you'll see the group board, which shows everyone's answers. You can like, comment on their post. And you can also post directly to the wall. So here you could post a question. You could also just record a video if you want and post that video. You can post a photo and so on. When you post directly to the wall, this will pop up in notifications and other people can see it and respond. A couple other things to highlight. Here is your workbook. You can actually download this when you're done, and this is a PDF that will include not only the content, but any answers that you have posted within the program. And this shows your progress, how long you've spent on it, what's left to be done. If you want to hide the completed actions and just see what else you need to do, you can do that as well. All right, let's get started. So click on the first session. This will take you to a little summary of what you're going to learn in this session. And then click on the first action to get started. Here we're going to read it. If you click on a hyperlink, it'll open it in the new window. I'll answer the poll. All right, now we're going to watch a video. If for some reason the video doesn't pop up, you can always open it in a separate window. And now we're going to answer a question. So type your answer in. And once you do that, you'll see an option here to share to group. Simply click on this if you want to share it to the group wall. If you don't click on that, your answer will stay just here in the platform for only you to see. But once you click share to group, if you click on view, you can then see everybody else's answers to that question, and you can comment or like on their answers. If you want to snap a picture or video, you can do that right here. Click on camera or click on record to record a video right here in the platform to upload to the group wall. Lastly, here you'll see the notes option. If you ever want to take notes on a lesson, just type your notes in here and click save, and you will always be able to access your notes. In the app, if you highlight some content and click on notes, that section will automatically be added to your notebook. Right, and that is how it works as a user.